Hello and welcome to Newsclick. I am Samedha and we're bringing you the glimpses of some of the stories that we followed at Newsclick. Workers from multiple sectors are up in arms against the Modi government. The latest protest is coming from the employees of the power sector. On December 13th, employees from the power sector held multiple protests and demonstrations in multiple regions of the country against the proposed amendments to the electricity bill, which was first introduced in 2014. This demonstration comes up as a run-up to the major protests that are going to happen in India on January 8th and 9th in 2019. The bill essentially proposes that a government company will lay down the wires and the distribution networks while a private manufacturer will actually be doing the selling of power. This essentially means that the private players will have more share on the profitable aspects of power distribution while not needing to make any investments. The bill is likely to be introduced in the winter session, which is ongoing right now. However, the workers are not resting without giving a tough challenge, which will lead to the scrapping of the bill. In a shocking statement, the Minister of the Gujarat Government for Forest and Tribal Development, Ramlal Patkar, said Hindu tribals who converted to other religion will not be entitled for the welfare schemes of the state government as per an amendment to the law. To explain this absurdity further, he said that there has been a new amendment by the Assembly, which suggests that non-tribals will not be eligible for the government schemes and development programs. But turns out there was no such amendment. After facing much heat and criticism coming from different quarters, Ganpat Vasava, who is the Cabinet Minister for Tribal and Forest Department, denied all claims and allegations and said that no such amendment was made. Patkar's statement is nothing new, given the fact that the right-wing party has been constantly trying to make the issue of conversion active after the anti-conversion law came into force. The Gujarat government in 2003 introduced the Freedom of Religion Act to regulate such religious conversions. It rings a bell, doesn't it? In December 2014, the Vishwa Hindu Parishad led a controversial Ghar Vapsi campaign where 200 Christian tribals had been converted to Hinduism. Talking of controversies, Meghalaya High Court Judge S.R. Sen said that India should have been declared a Hindu country. He said that we're Indians, good human beings, and thereafter comes the community to which we belong. He further went on to praise the Narendra Modi government by saying that I truly believe that only Narendra Modi ji understands the gravity of the situation. The statement comes in a shocking light. Given the political atmosphere of the country, a respected member of the judiciary giving a statement which can be interpreted as a subversion of the minority communities. The United Socialist Party of Venezuela, which was founded by Hugo Chavez in 2007, has won a massive 90% of the vote in the municipal elections which were held in the country. Despite a call for abstention made by the right wing, 28% of the population turned up to exercise their right to vote. The elections were held to elect 2,449 municipal councillors for a period of 2019 to 2022, and participants from across 51 parties contested in the election. The municipal elections that were held recently are the prime example of the functioning democracy of Venezuela. And given the fact that there was much pressure from the US and its right-wing allies in the region to demonize and delegitimize the elections. In May this year, Nicolas Maduro was elected as the president of Venezuela despite international calls for boycott and pressure coming from within the region. That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. Keep yourself updated and follow our stories on www.newsclick.in and follow us on Facebook as well as YouTube.